their asses whipped like you know.
As Yennefer of Vengerberg told it, there had been a magic explosion in Skellige. Related to Ciri's reappearance, it had destroyed a vast swath of forest. Geralt set out for the Isles to join the sorcerers and seek further clues of Ciri's whereabouts. The druid Ermion, however, had no intention of letting Yennefer examine the woods, so Geralt and Yen sought out Jarl Kraken Krait, who helped break down the druid's resolve.
We'll be done in a moment.
And then a giant sea snake swam up and bit my arm off. The gods have spoken. A sacrifice is needed.
To my mind, it's about you defeating a snake, Jarl.
No. They demand a sacrifice. I'm sure of it. It's time.
We must wait for a clearer sign. At least till your next dreaming.
I don't need no more signs.
Looking for Ceres. Heard she stayed here.
On Krait's daughter. Aye, she was here.
Where is she now?
What?
Ceres. Where's Ceres?
Dunno. Enough of the questions.
I say something wrong?
You must forgive the Jarl. Hasn't been feeling well of late.
Is he sick? He didn't seem quite right during Krach's feast, but...
Forgive me. I must go to him.
Where's Ceres? I've got to find her.
I don't know. Ask around.
Great.
Remember when that storm caused in Old Bay? Aye, like it were yesterday. Off gone fell overboard and near drowned.
Little Rick dove in the waves and saved them.
Because the gods directed them.
Grandson on the throne.
Hmm?
No black dog would dare set foot in Skellige.
Greetings. Hey!
What is she to you? The sorceress, Yennefer, right?
Well, what is it?
Hey, stranger. Looking for some entertainment? Want a drink?
What kind of entertainment you got in mind?
What? Why, beer, mead, and strong spirits. What do you expect in a tavern? Jump rope. I don't know where you're from, but I can see it's far off.
The Brokvar clan. Can you tell me about it?
We from the Brokvar clan are masters of the sea, bred and born to the water.
Not everyone in Skellige spend a lot of time in the water.
They think so too. But all they do is skim the top of it in their long ships, all wrapped up in heavy furs. From time to time, the wind blows a bit of spray from the oars in their faces. That's their only contact with water. Whereas our boys, as soon as they can walk, dive off cliffs into the very depths of the sea.
Show me what you have in stock. Take care.
Heard Ceres dropped in for a visit.
Nay, it is an honor to host Uncrate's daughter.
She come for a reason.
Sorry to interrupt.
You need something? Come, let's have a pint at a chat.
Thanks, but I'm short on time. Looking for a girl named Ceres.
Crachan Crate's daughter. She was here, but I've not seen her away.
Take care.
Not like me good for nothing, Sven.
Greetings.
Ha! Nary a soul for months, then one day guests from afar start dropping like rain in springtime. You weary traveler? Hungry?
Looking for Ceres, Jarl Uncrate's daughter.
Ah, you found her. Or near to. Lass was just here.
Know where she might have gone?
Took an interest in our Jarl. Asked about his childhood. So I told her to see Bergthora and Eirik.
Who are Bergthora and Eirik?
Years ago, Eirik was close with the old Jarl. Was the Jarl that helped him win Bergthora's hand. They lived toward the east end of the village.
Take care.
Bless you. And my blessings to Ceres when you see her. Kendall watches over Clan Fearset, but not a thing.
Greetings. I'm looking for someone.
Lucky chap you are, then. Truth be told, I'm taken. But village is brimming with lovely girls.
I'm looking for Ceres.
The skinny thing. Lovely doe eyes, true, and she's from an honorable house. But the lass is gaunt as a sapling.
I don't know where she is, and her father...
Ugh, tell Krach to calm down. No Skellige lass can perish in her own isles. All right, she was here a few hours. Went to find me man Eirik. Needed to talk, she said. They should be on the beach, t'other side of the isle.
Thanks. Take care.
Good luck searching.
Swarming like gulls around the waist, Ape. I'd be sure we showed them.
We? Seem to remember you sitting on that rock crying for help.
But if not for me warning, you'd be herring bait about now.
And if not for me, you'd have sat on that rock till you died and rotted.
For the love of Freya, all right. Have it your way. You saved me, now what? What, need I march around the country singing in your praises?
No. Just tell me where to find Ceres.
Must be daft. You helped me with the sea devils, but that don't mean I'm willing to gossip about Ancrate's daughter.
Think for a minute. If not for the Jarl, would I know to look for her here?
Right. So it's like the Jarl himself sent you. Should have said so at the start. She asked about our Jarl and his family. Went to Odeldrick's old family home. Yonder on the hill.
Thanks. Farewell.
Thank you.
seriously wrong here. Fresh footprints. Could be Ceres's. Ceres. Passed out. Gotta get her out of here.
What happened? Where am I?
Oh, my head. Pain's just awful.
Got hit with something heavy.
Geralt? Why are you here?
Came to look for you. Croc's worried. Taking you home.
I won't go until I help Ulrich.
The sword! Where's the sword? I've got to go back!
You're not going anywhere. I carried you out of there a moment ago, half dead.
I have to!
You have to tell me what's going on. So what's this sword all about?
It's Brokvar, the ancestral sword of Ulrich's clan. I need it to lift the curse that holds Ulrich.
A curse?
Long story. Years ago, Udalric and his little brother butted heads over the sword. As custom has it, the clan's sword should go to the firstborn son, Udalric. But his father gave Brokvar to his little brother, Aki.
Serious insult in these lands.
Serious enough for Udalric to break a sacred law here in Skellige. He openly questioned his father's decision.
Guessing the old Jarl couldn't let it pass.
They chained Udalric to a pile, up to his waist in the sea. Spent 3 days like that. When his punishment ended, he and Aki sailed out to fish.
Got a feeling this trip didn't end happily.
Your feeling's right. There was an accident. A storm broke out and Aki fell overboard. Udalric had his hands full with the sails. Didn't hear his brother until it was too late.
Didn't hear? Or didn't want to hear?
Some folk on the isle had the same doubt, but none would mention it aloud.
What did you plan to do with the sword?
I thought Aki's ghost would want it back.
The brother's ghost?
Long as I remember, folk have said Udalric's the chosen one. The one the gods speak to. I believed it once. But now, considering certain things, I think he's just haunted. And it's his dead brother that's haunting him.
So you believe Aki's getting his revenge, because Udalric let him die?
I've talked to Yort. He swears Udalric didn't start hearing voices till after Aki's death. And I don't think Yort's mistaken. He knew both those boys from the cradle. I think we've to give Brokvar to Aki, and he'll leave Udalric alone.
Not a bad idea, on condition it's a ghost we're dealing with. But something doesn't add up.
What's that?
Aki drowned at sea, said so yourself. But the ghost haunts this house.
Aki and Udalric both lived here. Maybe that's why. Thanks for your help, Geralt. But I've got to get the sword.
Out of the question. I'll get it.
Really? Thanks. So I can go see Udalric?
No chance. You're weak. Might pass out again along the way. Wait here. We'll go together. place about.
Find the sword?
I found it. Let's go.
After you, then.
You and my da, you were mates once, right?
Hope we still are.
But, well, I heard you fell out over something, or someone.
Talking about that story with Yennefer? Long time ago, that. In fact, that was before Krok met the woman who'd be your mother.
That you and Yennefer had already met?
Things were never cut and dried with Yen.
What is it about her? What is it that draws you?
Dunno. Maybe it's because I've never chosen comfort and ease, the calm and the quiet.
May your axe never crumble.
What can I do for you, traveler?
Can you trim my hair? Way it is now, it gets in my eyes. So long.
Where is Yennefer?
Don't know. Why do you ask?
I just wonder why she let you come here alone.
What do you mean, let me?
Nothing. Not a thing. Just got the impression she doesn't like to let you out of her sight.
Look, there they are.
Horridly bright out here. Stings the eyes.
The fresh air will do you good.
The gods won't be pleased.
Jarl, our guests, remember.
Couldn't help overhearing your conversation.
No worries. It's no secret.
All in the Isles know Jarl Udalric hears the voices of the gods.
These voices you hear?
The gods. Their voices.
It's not the gods.
Watch your words, foreigner. You're in Skelligar, our land, and we revere the gods here. If you weren't Onkreit's guest...
Jarl, the Witcher surely meant no offense. Let us hear what he has to say.
More likely this is somehow related to your dead brother.
I told Geralt of Aki. We concluded that...
That the gods are angry at you, yet he's the reason. That's why you have to apologize. To Aki himself.
I didn't want to. Aki fell in the water. The gods will be angry.
Angry you want to make peace with your brother? Are the gods of Skellige that cruel?
They are that just.
Justice demands you return to the dead what is rightly theirs.
What would you have me do?
Remember where Aki fell in the water?
Near the Isle's eastern end, by the mouth of the bay. Current had swept us towards Ulula's Needle.
It's a dangerous spot. Treacherous eddies swallow a handful of sailors each year.
We need to sail there. Aki's ghost won't rest until Brokvar's returned to his remains.
No. No, no, no. The gods, they'll be angry. I feel it.
Fear not, Jarl. The gods love you. And they loved Aki. Surely they want this.
Well, maybe I can sail there. The sword should be returned. That's what matters. Makes no difference by whose hand. What do I look for? Did Aki have anything that'll help me recognize him? Something he was wearing that could survive all this time underwater?
Aye. Our clan ring.
That ought to be enough. I'm off.
Axe. There's a weapon.
Ah! Oh!
Must be the place.
Thank you.
what that accomplished, if anything. Time to see Udalwick.
Why'd you do it?
What is this?
Udalwick. The voice has commanded him to poke out his eye.
What? Why'd you do it?
Such was the will of the gods. A sacrifice for Aki.
What did the gods want, exactly? Do you remember? What did they tell you?
They were angry. A voice said, "You vile wretch, you didn't help Aki, and now you failed to sail out to beg his forgiveness. Poke out your eye, suffer, and regret the evil you've wrought."
When did the gods speak to you? Right after I left?
Shortly after. Sleep came over me, so I lay down. 'Twas then they revealed their will to me.
You always asleep when they speak to you?
Always.
What do you see then? Do they try to summon you anywhere specific?
My old home. They command me to light torches, then speak from the shadows.
The gods always demand you offer them your suffering?
Only that pleases them, so they ask for more and more.
The gods ever show you their form, or are they always just a shadow?
Once, I steeled myself, gathered my courage, and in my dream made my torch burn bright. I saw a hazy figure sitting in shadow then.
The gods speak from the shadows, you said. Is that why you don't allow any lights in here?
In my dreams. At times I see their form, when the torches burn bright.
To see the gods is a great honor. Maybe with more light in your house, you'd see them when you're awake as well.
Lesser men are unworthy. They cannot gaze upon their faces.
I returned the sword, but nothing's changed. It's not his brother's ghost that haunts him, tortures him.
What's wrong with him?
Can we talk somewhere in private?
The guest room. Come. Well? Know what it is?
It's a Haim, a post-conjunction creature. Very rare and very dangerous. It latches on to men who commit vile deeds. It feeds on their pain for years, fueling their guilty conscience. In the end, Haims force their victims to mutilate themselves.
Sounds unpleasant. Any way to defeat it?
Two methods that work, in theory. Witcher's bestiaries say you have to spend a night in the Haim's lair, with the affected individual.
The haunted house, you mean? It's hardly cozy, but I wager you've slept in worse conditions.
It's not about sleeping. You've got to draw the Haim out. It has to emerge from the shadows, show itself. Can't hurt it otherwise.
And it's sure to give as good as it gets.
You've seen Udalric. It won't be an easy fight.
What's this other way?
They say a Heim can be tricked. You have to pretend to do something horrible. Then it'll move on to you as its new victim. When it realizes it's been tricked, it'll be forced to leave.
Great. Let's try it.
Don't know anyone who's pulled it off.
Well, maybe no one's thought up a trick that was good enough. I know you're doubtful, but we should at least try to find a way to trick the Heim.
Might not be as simple as it seems. Besides, neither method's perfect.
What do you mean?
Udalric might not survive an entire night in the Heim's lair.
You think the Heim... would it try to kill Udalric?
No, that would mean losing its host. But Udalric could just... expire. He's weak, and the house will summon painful memories. Whereas to the Heim, that'll be an opportunity. The more pain the Heim causes Udalric, the stronger it'll grow.
And the more dangerous it will be to you. And what about the other method?
The Heim's a demon, and demons are notoriously hard to fool. Plus, the trickster can't know it's a trick.
What?
The Heim attacks those who have a guilty conscience, truly believe they committed a foul deed. The Heim strengthens their regret and feeds on it. Meaning, if the new host doesn't feel true sorrow, the Heim will sense that.
Yes. So, for this to work, if either of us has an idea, we can't tell the other one about it.
Exactly.
Both methods seem risky, but I still think we should try the trick.
Don't know that I'm convinced.
Just please don't tell me you have to consult Yennefer on such things as well. If we fail to think of anything, we can always try the Witcher's way.
What is it with you and Yennefer? Mentioned her several times already.
Nothing. I've just noticed that you're often of one mind.
Saying I'm henpecked.
Not that you're especially different. Seems to happen to all men. Take a rowdy Skelliger, a brave knight, or a tough witcher. You all end up wrapped around some woman's finger.
So to prove you wrong, I gotta do what you say now?
As long as my name is not Yennefer, no one will call you henpecked for that. And remember, if we can't think of a good trick, we can still do it your way.
Fine, let's try to trick the Heim.
Good decision.
Haunted house, the Heim's lair. Only place where anything like this could work.
After you, then.
No reason to delay. Solid craftsmanship. Fitter must have been from the continent. Ciri. No, it's impossible. Damn it. Looking to discourage me? Good. Means you're scared. Solid craftsmanship. Fitter must have been from the continent. Somebody could break their leg or their neck. Shattered. Udalric must have been scared of seeing the creature just behind him. An old cradle. Must have belonged to Udalric or Aki.
Geralt!
With anything?
Yes, I have a plan. One that just might work.
Can I get any details?
You've got to wait for me here. I won't be long.
Anything else?
Said yourself, you can't know the details. So no, nothing else. You simply gotta trust me.
Hope you know what you're doing.
So do I. So, can we start?
I'm ready.
All right, I'll be back soon. In the meantime, get a fire going in the oven.
Over there! She's running to the old house!
Grab her!
Take him. You must put him in the oven. Trust me.
Take care not to hurt the child. Give me the bee.
In the oven. Throw him in the oven. The Witcher committed no crime. You'll find neither despair nor guilt here. Only shock and relief. You've been tricked. You must go.
It's over.
Over?
We tricked the Heim. It thought I'd killed your child, abandoned you to haunt me, feed on my conscience.
But when it saw the babe was whole, unharmed, it had to go. You're free, Jarl.
Free?
The Heim's gone. So are the voices that tortured you. Let's get out of here.
What's happening? My head's spinning. I'm spinning in a maelstrom.
Geralt, you said it was over.
That's just fatigue. In time, his mind will return to normal.
What? What will I do now?
You'll be fine. key is to not give in to self-pity.
I feel as if someone's torn something from me.
That's normal. The Heim was a parasite. Bonds between parasites and hosts can be strong. That's why you feel empty now. Give it a few days, weeks, you'll be fine.
Thank you. I think. Farewell.
I'll go with him. He seems confused.
Good idea. Then what? What are your plans?
I'll stay a few days, make sure he's healthy. And you? Gonna stay on Speakerog?
Don't know yet. Gotta gather my thoughts.
I'm sure Yennefer must be growing impatient.
Thought we already discussed that.
We did. Farewell, Witcher. Favorable winds and following seas to you.
To you too. So long. Got a minute? Farewell.
Blade's not worth shite if a weak arm swinging an ape.
Master Geralt. A guard spotted you from the tower. They sent me to open the gates.
Why was it closed? Is that famous Skellige hospitality?
Me. 'Tis tradition. After the feast, the Jarls will choose the king, so the doors must remain closed. Only the sons and daughters of Skellige may stay in the castle.
Krach make an exception just for me?
All know what you did for Ceres and Hjalmar. Today, you're one of us. Come. Krach awaits.
How's the mood in there?
Calm. Too calm.
How's that?
We've an adage here at Skellige. At a good feast, mead and blood flow in equal measure. Surely you consider this barbaric on the continent, no?
Not sure. Sounds preferable to dull banquets garnished with court intrigue.
Step careful there. I've as much right to it as you do!
And I'd expect you to support me, not pinch my allies. If an Onkrait's to wear the crown, it...
should be you, because you've got fur growing on your chin, that it?
Show some of your own, and the Jarls just might listen to you.
What, your mug smacked? Remember, I was left standing last time we crossed fists.
Yeah? So you'll fight the Vilkarls with me? Wonder who'll do better, you or Hjalmar the Giant Slayer?
Oh, stop your shite, boasting!
Ceres! Hey, God damn it!
Don't see Krach. He talking to the Jarls?
No, went to his chambers. To prepare your promised reward, no doubt.
If you've a spell, Witcher, perhaps you'd fancy some fisticuffs with the Vilkards. Loosen up your joints after your journey.
Maybe later.
Best place not worth shite if a weak arm is swinging it.
Where are these goblins from?
Temple to the
friends we show heart, foes we show grass.
You hear the black ones shift.
Greetings, Berna. Feast not to your liking?
This is no feast. It's a farmer's market where votes are bought and sold like sheepskins.
Leaving Caer Torolda?
Tomorrow at daybreak.
Enjoy yourself, Master Geralt.
May I?
You must, even. Come! I've been waiting for you. So, feast to your liking? Any better than your continental balls?
Definitely more to drink.
Aye, there is. Rolled all of it out of my cellars. Double meads, triple, Cintrian plum brandy, Mahakamum spirit that burns the mouth like boiling water. Clan on Crate knows the meaning of hospitality.
Saw you talking to Berna. What about?
Politics. After all, naught else interests her. Wench tried to convince me that we must honor Bran's memory. And to that aim, I'm to command my offspring to withdraw from the race for the crown. Support Svanrigger instead.
Why do I think you turned her down?
You put it mildly. I showed her the door.
Feeling torn between Hjalmar and Saris?
You mean, do I have a favorite? Nay. They're as different as fire and water. But on Crate blood flows in both.
Think the Council of Jarls will dare to put a woman on the throne?
If you'd asked me some months ago, I'd have laughed in your face. But today I see, and I'm not alone, that Ceres has something as rare on the Isles as a hot summer. Patience. Others act, then think. She's different. She thinks things through, the for, the against. But once she takes action, not a force in the world could stop her.
Promised me a reward for helping your children.
And I aim to keep my word. Here. This bauble's been in the family for generations. I give it to you for helping ensure the line endures.
Beautiful craftsmanship. Thanks.
I'm the one.
Not Hjalmar. Let's go.
cloth! Give me some cloth! Gotta stop the bleeding. Quick!
Da. Da.
Take my cloak.
Hold on, son. You'll pull through. A shark grabbed my leg once. Albion!
He's dead.
Crack! Where'd those bears come from,
huh?
Answer! Now!
Careful how you speak to my dad.
Stow your blade, pup, or Crack will lose a son too.
You insult me, Lugoth, and now you threaten my son. I will not step to this.
Dad, come here. Come on! Put you down like a rabbit dog.
Calm down, calm down. Enough blood's been spilled. Someone brought these beasts here to murder our sons and brothers. We cannot restore their lives, but we can, we must avenge them. This burden falls upon the host and his offspring.
Find the guilty on Crete. Find and kill them. Else your clan will be cursed for 100 generations to come.
Anybody see how the bears got in?
Don't matter. I know where to find the guilty already.
Wait! Are you mad? You're gonna kill folk before we've learned what happened.
Learn all you want. Meantime, I'll go wash the shame off our clan.
Hey, the Jarls aren't listening anymore. Stop playing the hero and think for a second.
Our honor's at stake, sis. I can't wait.
Are you listening to me? Someone let those bears in. We must know who, and the answer lies somewhere in this room.
You're right, Ceres. I'll help you.
Thanks.
Fine. See you when I return with the traitor's heads.
I'll stay here. Someone must see to everything. Summon the healer, hand the fallen over to their families. Wolf, I thank you.
Ever see anything like that?
No, and I hope I never will again.
Where'd the bears come from? We were all laughing, eating, drinking. Suddenly, a massacre. Torrents of blood on the walls.
What happened before the massacre? Be precise.
Young Lugoth bet he could empty a barrel of beer in one go. He climbed on the table, grabbed a pony keg of Sintern wheat, and started chugging. His throat bulged like a blowfish. Face went red, but he kept drinking. Folks started banging their tankards on the table, shouted, "Lugoth, Lugoth." Then, from the other side of the room, we heard this roar. We turned in unison as if a coxswain had called. They were there. They were already there. Folks closest to the bears didn't even manage to draw their weapons. They were ripped to shreds.
We'll avenge them, I promise. We've talked enough. Let's look around.
Let me know what you find. I'll speak to the others. Maybe someone saw more than I did. Pull yourself together, Cinna.
Fang marks, claw marks, broken bones. Hard to say what exactly killed him. All right. What do we have here? Bear's head, but the tongue's short, like a human's. Mouth smells of honey liqueur. Mead. And something else. Something earthy. Bears like honey. Before it's fermented. Strange. Something under the fur. A tattoo? Shape of a bear paw. Old scar. Looks like it was sutured.
Half man, half bear. Something like a lycanthrope. No full moon, so something else caused the transformation. Maybe something he ate or drank. Mead. Mead with an earthy aroma. Need to check the horns, tankards, and bowls. All the horns are empty. Aldrig. Shit, no more than a kid. Earthy scent from the bear's maw. Something towards mushrooms? Bowls empty. But the scent's in the air. Coming from somewhere else in this room.
What'll you witchers do once there are no basilisks, leshens, or giants around? Eh?
Here. Mead spiked with some kind of mushroom. And human blood?
Ceres, come here.
A guard saw what happened. Those weren't bears. They were...
men who transform into bears.
Uh-huh. Berserkers.
Think I know what caused them to transform. The mead they drank. Smell this. Mead spiked with blood, and something else. Thinking it could be a mushroom, but I don't recognize the type.
Hjort might help us. Few druids know herbs better.
Can't hurt to try.
Why so pale? White whale bite your hook.
A disgrace. The camp would not sink since the wrecked funeral.
Freyr, our mother. May the sea swallow the traitors. Freyr, our lady.
Mind if I interrupt?
Already have? What is it?
Someone spiked one of the mead barrels with blood and something else. An herb or a mushroom. Ceres said...
Give me the horn. I know the smell. A mushroom. Mardrom.
Mardrom. Never heard of it.
You've another name for it on the continent. Psilocyb, I believe.
All right. Peasants eat it to soothe pain.
Udalric tried it too, but only a few times. In larger doses, the mushroom causes visions, nightmares.
Yes, the last thing Udalric needed more of. Thanks for your help. Blood and mardrum. The taste of human flesh and a substance that triggers visions. That well could have caused the rage. Maybe even the transformation.
Maybe. Hard to believe someone spiked the mead here in the hall, though, in front of all those witnesses.
You're right. I helped prepare for the feast. I'd have noticed. It might have happened before they brought the drink upstairs. In the cellars, maybe? Come on. We could find some clues there. We must find the traitors quickly. Elsewise, the warriors will take matters into their own hands. Castle's abuzz already.
Think they'd attack Krok openly?
My father or each other. All in the finest Skellige tradition. Haven't had a good civil war in ages.